Welcome to online classes by Technocrats International School. This is the class of computers where we are going to study what is a computer system, what does it mean, and for your convenience I have mentioned all the topics that we are going to discuss in today's class. We are going to discuss about the label diagram of a computer, the definition of a computer, computer terminology, in which we will discuss these 6 points: data, process, information, hardware, software, and user. And lastly, we will be discussing about the working of a computer. So, are you even curious to know that from where has this word computer been derived? We everyday see computers and we work on them, but how many of us actually know that what it means and from where this word has actually been derived? So, the word computer has been derived from the term compute. Compute means to calculate or count. The word compute means calculate or count. And with this, we can easily see that the computer does so many calculations and performs everyday tasks for us. And all these tasks are performed on the basis of these arithmetical and operational calculations performed by a computer. Okay, so I hope that this is clear to you. What does compute and what does calculate or count means? And now we will be discussing the meaning of system. What is a system? We are not saying just computer. We are calling it to be a computer system. So what is a system? System means a combination or a collection of components. Now, what are these components? Because computer is not a single machine. It is a collection of hardware and software components. When brought together, they perform the tasks for us. So for this, we need to see the labeled diagram of a computer system. This is the diagram, and we can see this is the monitor, this is the keyboard, this is the CPU, and this is the mouse, this is a printer, and these are the speakers. These two are optional components. You may have it or you may not have it, but these four components are must to have. Monitor is also known as an output device. And in your previous class, you might have studied that what is an output device. An output device is a device that shows you the output or that shows you the result. So you can see your results and outputs on the monitor. The monitor displays it all for you. So it is an output device. Then comes the keyboard. The keyboard is an input device. Now, what is an input device? An input device is a device which is used to give inputs to the computer. When you give some input, then only you will get the desired output. Unless and until you give the input to the computer will not have any instructions from the user, and so it will not perform any task. So for that you need to give inputs, and it can be given through any input device. In this case we have a keyboard, but there are many more input devices other than keyboards which we will study in further classes. Then comes the mouse. Mouse is also an input device like the keyboard. You use it by scrolling your fingers on the mouse. It has a trackball on it, and you can give inputs with the help of this. You can place the cursor on the screen with the help of your mouse, drag and drop things with the help of the mouse. Then comes the CPU. CPU is that hardware component of the computer which is responsible for the processing of your instructions. This is actually called as the central processing unit. The central processing unit is responsible for the processing of instructions or inputs being given to the computer by the user. Then comes the printer. Printer is again an output device which gives you the outputs. For example, you work on your school assignments and projects and you need some printouts of some pictures on a piece of paper. then you use a printer for that. Then comes the speakers. Speakers are also output devices. When you want to listen to music without using your headphones, you just want the noise to be loud and clear, you use speakers for that. So these are also output devices. So when all these components, these devices are also called as components, when all these components are brought together, then a computer system is formed. Alright? So a computer is not just a monitor or a keyboard or a CPU. When all of these are brought together, then only a computer system is formed. So computer is not a single machine, it is a system. Now, we have discussed the label diagram of a computer. Now we'll be discussing about the definition of a computer. What is the definition? So, a computer is an electronic device. Why we are calling it to be an electronic device? Because this works on electricity. If there is no electric supply to the computer, it won't start, it won't work. So, a computer is an electronic device which processes the instructions given by the user and then gives you the desired output or the result. This is the definition of a computer. So, I will be writing this definition on the board. Computer is an electronic device or machine which processes the input given by the user and produces the output. This is the simple definition of a computer. Then, now we will be discussing the computer terminology. First, computer terminology. Terminology means simple terms that a computer uses. These are some definitions or words that are used very frequently when we talk about computer. That is why we are calling them to be the terminologies. So we need to know what is the meaning of these terms. The first term is data. What is a data? Data means a collection of raw facts and figures. We are calling these figures and facts to be raw. Raw means something which is unprocessed. For example, there are 26 alphabets in English, but all these 26 alphabets are simply data. They don't have a meaning until and unless we start creating words out of those alphabets. Okay, C-A-T, cat, D-O-G, dog. When you create these words from those alphabets, then these words become some information. And when these are simply written, for example, A, B, C, D, this is data. So we have covered two terms from there. One is data and the other is information. Information means meaningful processing of data. When that data is processed, raw data or unprocessed data is processed to derive some meaning from that, then it becomes information. Then process, what do you mean by process? Process is something which is the way of doing some action on that data to create some information. A system works like this. We have given English alphabets as input and then we are doing processing because we have learned some spellings and we know the spellings of some words, so we will be creating those words from our knowledge. This is known as process. We are processing those alphabets and then we are creating some words from those alphabets. So this is data and this is information, and this is derived unless and until you don't do the process, this cannot be. derived. I hope this is clear to you. Now we will be discussing what is hardware and software. Hardware is the physical components that are associated with a computer. All these physical devices like the CPU, mouse, keyboard, monitor, speakers, printers, these are all hardwares that you can touch, physical components. Then comes the software. Software means set of instructions. This is something which you cannot touch. For example, the paint, Microsoft Paint on which you do your painting projects on your computer, it is not a hardware, it is a software. It is a set of instructions. Similarly, your operating system, it is also a software. It is not a hardware which you cannot touch, but still it is there inside the computer. These are known as the software components. Then comes the user. User is someone who is performing tasks on a computer. So a user is very important because a computer will not work on its own. It needs a user to give instructions to it. So the user can be me or you, your friends and your parents, anybody who is using a computer is known as a user. Then the working of a computer. How does a computer work? So there is a very simple block diagram that can explain how a computer works. A computer takes input, then it processes that input, and then it gives you the desired output. This is the simplest block diagram that explains how a computer works. For example, you want to drink an orange juice. So the orange juice is something that you want as a result. You want it as an output. So you know that orange juice is prepared from oranges. So oranges is going to be the input. And now how do you prepare a juice with the help of those oranges? You need a fruit juicer. So this process is going to be done by the juicer. And then after the oranges are given as an input into the juicer will process it and create orange juice, which will be the ultimate output you needed. In the same manner, the computer works. For example, you want to do a mathematical problem. You want to do the addition of two numbers. You want to add 2 plus 3. Okay, and you want a result. So the numbers 2 and 3 and this operator addition will be given as an input. So 2 and 3 we will be giving as an input, and then the processor. In case of the computer, the processor is the CPU. So this CPU is responsible for carrying out this mathematical operation. So the CPU will do the process of adding these two numbers. And then lately you will get the result 5, which is the output. So this is how a computer works. This is the simple block diagram for it. And I hope that this class was clear to you all and you all could understand what I was trying to tell you. If you have any doubts, you can note your doubts and you can send the doubts on your WhatsApp group, and we'll be very happy to solve your problems. And please wait for the next video. Till then, take care of yourselves and keep studying. Thank you.